Hello everyone. Hello everyone and welcome back to state level lecture of science 2. And I am Shilpa Chhatrapan from Vikhroli Park site. And today we are going to learn about whatever was left in the last lecture because of a device problem. There was a means I can't share my screen last time, so please bear with that problem, and today we are continuing with that lecture only. Okay, so we are going to study about the next part of lesson number 3, that is life processes in living organisms part 2. So let's revise some important points which we have discussed in our previous lecture. Okay, in the last lecture we have seen that there are two types of reproduction, that is, one is sexual and other one is asexual reproduction. In that, in asexual reproduction, we have seen that how in unicellular and multicellular organisms it takes place. Now, let's revise once again whatever we have discussed on unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium and euglena. We have in amoeba we have seen due to having no specific shape, it divides in any axis. We have seen that. So it is called as simple binary fission, and it gets divided into any plane. So its name is simple binary fission. And in paramecium, what we have seen, paramecium, it gets divided transversely into two parts. So this type of division is called as transverse binary fission. And the name indicates how the division takes place. And in the third division, it takes place longitudinally. Means from top to the bottom. So in euglena, this type of division is called as longitudinal binary fission. So these three types we have discussed during binary fission. That is, binary fission includes three types: simple, transverse, and longitudinal binary fission. Now after that, we discussed about multiple fission in unicellular organisms. That is, we have discussed about amoeba, how it performs multiple fission whenever there is adverse conditions like lack of food, water, and amoeba stops formation of pseudopodia and thereby movements and becomes rounded and forms a protective covering around its plasma membrane, and it forms a cyst-like structure. So in this cyst, many nuclei are formed by repeated nuclear division, and it is followed by cytoplasmic division. And thus, many amoebulae are formed and they remain encysted till there are adverse conditions, and this cyst breaks and opens on arrival of favorable conditions, and many amoebulae are released as it is shown in the slide. Okay, so in this way, whenever there are favorable conditions, the cyst breaks and it releases amoebulae, and thus this multiple fission takes place. Now, then after, we discussed about budding, budding in unicellular organisms. So we also performed an activity. We took lukewarm water, we added some yeast and sugar, and then we observed it under microscope. And after 1 hour, a small bulge-like structure was seen appearing. And it started to grow, and the nucleus starts dividing into two daughter nuclei as shown in the figure. and it divides mitotically and after sufficient growth separates from the main parent and lives independently as daughter yeast cell. This experiment or this activity we have seen in our previous lecture. So now let's move forward to another type of asexual reproduction, which takes place in multicellular organisms by five different types, that is fragmentation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, and spore formation. So now let's discuss about fragmentation. In this type, what happens in this type of reproduction? The body of parent organism breaks up into many fragments, means it divides itself into many fragments, and each fragment starts to break and it starts to live as an independent new organism, means each part breaks and it performs as an individual part, and it grows again into a parent organism. So this type of reproduction occurs in algae like Spirogyra and sponges like Cycon. Whenever there is plenty of water, means when there is a rainy season and nutrients are available to the Spirogyra, its filaments grow up very fast and break up into many small fragments, and each fragment starts to live independently as a new Spirogyra fiber. Now, if the body of a Cycon breaks up accidentally into many fragments, each fragment develops into new Cycon in this way. This is a Cycon. Okay, so after breaking up, it develops into new Cycon. Each fragment develops into new Cycon. So in fragmentation, the body of that organism breaks up and each part develops into new and independent organism. So now after learning about fragmentation, let's move to our next type of asexual reproduction, that is regeneration. Now, what is regeneration? Look at the picture. Now, have you seen a wall lizard moving on walls in your house? Have you seen? Yes, I think all of you have seen a wall lizard in your house. So if you have observed it carefully, you may know that some of the time, what happens? The wall lizard breaks up and discards some part of its tail in emergency. Means if it thinks that it is a emergency time, that what the lizard does, it discards its tail and it means it runs away from that means particular area. So the discarded part, means the tail, is regenerated after a period of time, means the tail is gained and is regenerated after a period of time, means it gains its tail after discarding it. Now, by the lizard, once again after losing it, this is an example of limited regeneration, means after discarding the part, if you think if your any body part is discarded, then can you regenerate your part? No, if there is a, if your bone breaks, you can't regenerate it again. Okay, so but in this type of means asexual reproduction of lizard, it can again gain its tail by regeneration process, but this part, means it only discards its tail. It's limbs are not discarded or its head is not discarded. Only it can discard its tail and it can regenerate the tail only. So this type of regeneration is a limited regeneration process. So an animal, like the name of that animal is planaria. It what happens under certain situations, it breaks up its body into two parts, means it can break its body into two parts, and that each part thereafter regenerates remaining part of the body, and thus two new planaria are formed. Means in this type, if the planaria breaks up, it can develop into new organism. Now this development is called as regeneration, means it can divide itself into two and it can regenerate the remaining part of its body. So this is the example of regeneration. Planaria is the example of regeneration. Okay, so previously we have seen budding in reproduction of unicellular organisms. In our last lecture we have seen that. So in case of multicellular organisms also, this asexual reproduction takes place by budding. But how it takes place, just we will have a look. So in case of hydra, under favorable conditions, means in whenever it has plenty of food, plenty of nutrients, what happens at specific part of its body, an outgrowth is formed. Means there is a small outgrowth seen in the body of the hydra. So this outgrowth which comes out by the side is called as bud. This outgrowth which comes from its body, it is called as bud. Now this bud grows up progressively and finally forms a small hydra. You can see here how in this previous figure it is a small bud like structure, but after some time it grows in a small hydra. Okay, and its dermal layers and digestive cavity of the budding hydra, and the bud grows up progressively and finally forms a small hydra, and the dermal layers and digestive cavity of the budding hydra are in continuity with those of parent hydra. Okay, so the parent hydra supplies nutrition, that is food, to the budding hydra. Okay, so the budding means the parent hydra, it provides all the nutrients, food and everything to the small hydra. And after that, what happens? The budding hydra separates from the parent hydra and starts to lead an independent life when it grows up and becomes able to lead an independent life like this. So previously it means it separates and then it lives a independent life. Okay, so this is the type of reproduction, asexual reproduction of budding in multicellular organisms. So after discussing about budding, now let's move to the another type of reproduction, that is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation, it is seen in plants. This type of reproduction in plants is formed by the vegetative parts like root, stem, leaf and buds in plants. Okay, so this is called as vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation. So in potatoes, and this vegetative propagation is performed with the help of eyes, present on the tuber or the stem of potato. So these eyes grow into new plant, and with the help of vegetative propagation, what happens? These eyes grow into new plant, and with the help of vegetative propagation, it takes place in potato, and new plant is developed from the eyes or the buds, which are which outgrowth come from the potato plant or the potato stem. Okay, so in the case of bryophyllum, the leaf margin performs reproduction with the help of buds present on the leaf margin. You can see there are buds on the leaf margin, means on the corners of the leaf there are buds which you can see. Okay, so the leaf departs from the plant and new plant develops from the buds present on the leaf margin. So whenever the leaf is discarded from the plant, the leaf it performs a new, means it develops into new plants from that leaf only. From the leaf margin, the buds come out, and from that new plant is formed. Now, in case of plants like sugarcane and grasses, vegetative propagation occurs with the help of buds, means which are present on the nodes. The sugarcane has nodes on it, on its stem. So the nodes help to perform development in formation of new plant, like the carrot and radish. In the carrot and radish also, this type of vegetative propagation occurs, and thus new plant is developed from these nodes or these means this in this type the new plant is formed. Now let's move to the last reproduction of asexual in multicellular, that is spore formation. Spore formation means what happens, you will see in this activity we will perform an activity for this means type of reproduction, how it occurs. So let's do an activity. So for that we will take a piece of wet bread or bhakri and keep it in humid place, like in a tiffin box. Okay, we keep the moist bread in the tiffin box. What will happen, we are going to see in this activity. So cover the tiffin box for 2 to 3 days, and after opening its lid after 3 days, what will you see? You will see fungus growing on the bread. You will see a cottony mass of fungus growing on the surface of the bread. So we will see how it looks. We can see only a cottony mass of fungus with our naked eyes, but under microscope we can see the difference. Okay, so take a piece of fungus on a clean slide and cover it with the cover slip, and then observe it under the microscope. Whatever fungus we want to see, we can see under the microscope. So you see that fungi like mucor have a filamentous body on the surface. Okay, you can see this type of fungus in the microscope. So they have sporangia, which appears as a bulb-like structure on the mucor. Okay, so once the spores are formed, sporangia bursts and spores are released from it. So in this way, the spores are released, and these spores germinate in moist and warm place and new fungal colony is formed. So whenever the spores they get burst on and they spread on the moist bread, they will form a new fungal colony. Means again one fungus will grow on it. So in this way, we have learned about asexual reproduction in detail. We have seen all the types in multicellular and unicellular. Now let's move to our another topic, that is sexual reproduction. Now sexual reproduction always occurs with the help of two germ cells. Now these two germ cells are male and female gamete. So these male gamete and female gamete, they are called as germ cells. Okay, these germ cells means male and female gamete. Okay, so there are two main processes which occur in sexual reproduction. Which two processes? First one is gamete formation. First one is what? Gamete formation. And second one is fertilization. Okay, so these two main processes are which occur in sexual reproduction. Okay, so in gamete formation, gametes are formed by the meiosis. So what is meiosis? In meiosis, what happens? Chromosome number is reduced to half, hence haploid gametes are formed. Means if 2a number of chromosomes are there, then it will be reduced to half, that is n number of chromosomes. So mitosis and meiosis, these processes are detailedly discussed in this lesson. In our next lectures, we will see the detailed process. So just have a you will have to only understand this time what meiosis is and mitosis. In detail, we will see these two processes in our next lecture. Okay, just you understand what happens. So in meiosis, chromosome number is reduced. You just understand that in meiosis what happens and in mitosis what happens. Okay, so hence haploid gametes are formed. Means they are diploid. First the chromosome is diploid, but after the meiosis process, it becomes haploid. Okay, haploid means half. Okay, so in fertilization, this half chromosome unite together, means half or n number of chromosomes, one from male and one from female gamete. Okay, so these half and half both come together, and means half means haploid. Okay, as they are half in number, they are called as haploid gamete. And when they unite, they become 2n in number, that is diploid gamete. Okay, means diploid means double. Haploid means half. Okay, so when half and half they unite, they become diploid gamete. Okay, so again, so a diploid gamete or the diploid zygote is formed in this process by union of haploid male and female gamete. The zygote divides by mitosis and embryo is formed. After union of these two gametes, means male and female gametes, then what happens? The zygote then undergoes mitotic division, means it undergoes a mitosis, in a mitosis process, and divides, and a embryo is formed here. Now the embryo develops to form a new individual. Okay, when the embryo performs development, what happens? A new individual is formed here. And in this process, two parents, that is male parent and female parent, are involved in this type of reproduction. So fusion of male gamete of male parent and female gamete of female parent occurs in this process, and a new progeny or a offspring is formed here. Now, due to this, what happens? A new individual always has the recombined genes of both the parents. So the new individual shows some similarities with parents for some characters and has some characters different than the both parents. Means you see, you look similar to your parents. You look like your mother or you look like your father. There are some similarities, means your nose, your eyes, your lips, your earlobe, they are similar to your mother or father. Okay, so these are the similarities, but some differences also can be seen. So this is because of means genetic variation due to meiosis process. Okay, so for example, if one parent has black eyes and one parent has brown eyes, in this process what happens, you see, for example, what happens, one parent has black eyes and one parent has brown eyes. Now the offspring may show one character similar as to one parent and may differ in some characters like blood group. Means see, here the male parent is having black eyes and the female parent is having brown eyes, and the offspring, means the individual, what it shows, it shows brown eyes, means its eyes are like its mother. Okay, the eyes, it is not similar of the father. Okay, so it shows similar character from its mother. Now here, the male parent or the father has free earlobe and the mother has attached earlobe, but the offspring shows free earlobe. Means here it takes the characters of its father, not the mother. Now some character it takes from parent, means male parent, means father, or it takes some characters from the mother. So combination of genes you can see in that offspring. The blood group of the father is A, and the mother it is B, but the offspring has the blood group O, means it is not similar to the father and it is not similar to the mother also. It is different from both of them. So this is the different character shown in the offspring. Means some characters are like their parents, means they are similar to the parents, but some characters, they are different from the both parents. Okay, so this is what we say, genetic variation in the offspring. This happens due to meiosis. Now genetic variation helps the organism to adjust with the changing environment and thereby to maintain their existence. Means due to genetic variation, what happens? The offspring or the new organism which is formed, which gets adjusted to the changing environment, and it maintains its existence. And the diversity in living organisms occurs due to this genetic variation. So due to this, what happens? Plants and animals can save themselves from being extinct. Diversity occurs due to genetic variation. Means what happens if the species gets exhausted or extinct, then we can't see that species anymore. So due to genetic variation, what happens? There comes a diversity in that species, and due to this diversity, genetic variations are seen, and you will see means that species will not extinct with the changing environment. Some species, they can't adjust themselves with the changing environment. So this helps, genetic variation helps that organism to adjust with the changing environment. So there are some means questions in your textbook, like think a little. So what are the answers to that questions? We will discuss here. So what would have happened if the male and female gametes had been diploid? And this is the question in your textbook. So the answer to this question is, if the male and female gametes have been diploid, then the zygote formed after fertilization would had been tetraploid. Means if in the cell, means in the meiosis, if the meiosis process was not in this, means if meiosis is not there, what does in mitosis, what will have been happen? So the 2n number of gametes from male and 2n number of female gametes, they will unite and they will form tetraploid. Means the new offspring will be not the same like its parents. It would be like, means doubled. It would be doubled in chromosomes, and it must be looking, means we can't imagine about that offspring. Okay, so the meiosis, it helps to maintain the chromosome number in the offspring. Okay, so what would have happened if any of the cells in nature had not been divided by meiosis? If meiosis process was not there, what would have been happened if? So the answer to this question is, if any of the cells in nature had not been divided by meiosis, then sexual reproduction would had not taken place, as the process of meiosis is very essential for gamete formation. So the gametes which are formed, they are formed by only the meiosis process, and this sexual production would not have been happened if there was not means meiosis process. So the sexual reproduction, it requires meiosis process. So up till now, whatever we have discussed, just we will recall all the points. So we saw about asexual reproduction in unicellular, and in that we studied about three types, that is binary fission, multiple fission, and budding. And in binary fission, there we saw three types, that is simple binary fission, transverse binary fission, and longitudinal binary fission. Now after that, in asexual reproduction in multicellular, we have studied the five types, that is fragmentation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, and spore formation. We have discussed all these points of multicellular organisms, and how the asexual reproduction takes place. Now, in sexual reproduction, we have learned about the gamete formation of male and female gametes, how the fertilization process takes place, how the genetic variation in species is seen, and how the diversity is seen in the species. So we have discussed all these points today in our today's lecture. So if you have any doubt, you can ask. So any student? You can ask your doubts.
रितेश यादव अनम्यूट हुआ सर. आस्क योर डाउट.
मैम कैन यू एक्सप्लेन मेल गैमेट.
मेल गैमेट ओके. व्हाट यू वांट टू नो अबाउट द मेल गैमेट. Now the male gamete, if you want to know about this gamete in detail in our next lecture, about the male gamete, how it is formed, then female gamete, how it is formed, and whole process we are going to discuss in our next lecture. Means in humans how the reproduction takes place, that process we are going to discuss in detail in our next lecture. Okay, today we only have seen how the male gamete is formed and female gamete is formed and they unite and how a offspring is formed. Okay, so in detail we are going to see about these all reproductive systems in our next lecture. There you will means your doubt will be clear in that lecture. Anyone, if you have any doubt in asexual reproduction of unicellular or multicellular, you can ask. But of this human part, we will discuss in our next lecture in detail.
Samad.
Good evening, miss. Good morning, miss. Sorry.
Good morning, beta.
Miss, मुझे ये पूछना था, miss, doubt है मुझे fragmentation. What mean fragmentation? Miss, वो नहीं समझा मुझे.
Fragmentation. Okay, okay. क्या नहीं समझा उसमें?
Fragmentation.
Okay. Fragmentation. तो फ्रेगमेंटेशन में क्या होता है कि जो स्पायर वगैरह होता है वो क्या करता है, खुद की बॉडी को ब्रेक करता है इनटू मेनी पार्ट्स. खुद की बॉडी को वो ब्रेक करता है और ब्रेक होने के बाद उसमें से न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म फिर से तैयार होता है. यानी एक फ्रेगमेंट अगर तीन में डिवाइड हुआ तो फिर तीन नए ऑर्गेनिजम्स उसमें से बनते हैं. यही है फ्रेगमेंटेशन प्रोसेस.
यस,
समझ में आ गया?
यस मिस. और एक और मिस.
हाँ बोलो, पूछो.
रीजेनरेशन.
रीजेनरेशन. ओके. रीजेनरेशन में व्हाट हैपेंस, देखो जैसे आपने आपके घर में लिजार्ड देखी होगी. तो लिजार्ड क्या करता है, जब भी इमरजेंसी आती है वो अपनी टेल यानी के छोड़ देता है, और फिर से उसको यानी के फिर से वो टेल उसको आ जाती है. धीरे धीरे टाइम पीरियड लगता है उसको, लेकिन वो अपनी टेल फिर से यानी के उगा लेता है. तो उसी तरह से जो एक एनिमल है, मीन्स द एनिमल नेम प्लैनेरिया. प्लैनेरिया क्या करता है, अगर उसको कोई इमरजेंसी आ गई या फिर उसको अगर कुछ सर्टन कंडीशंस में उसको अगर डिवाइड होने की जरूरत पड़ी तो वो खुद की बॉडी को टू पार्ट्स में डिवाइड कर लेता है, और डिवाइड होने के बाद वो फिर से अपनी बॉडी, यानी डिवाइड होने के बाद भी वो बाकी के पार्ट्स अपने अपने डेवलप कर लेता है. इस तरह से वो रीजनरेशन की प्रोसेस करता है. यानी अगर उसका एक पार्ट अगर चला गया, ऊपर का पार्ट अलग हो गया, नीचे का पार्ट अलग हो गया, तो उसमें से नीचे के पार्ट में ऊपर का पार्ट रीजनरेट होता है, और जो ऊपर का पार्ट में नीचे का पार्ट नहीं रहता है वो नीचे का पार्ट भी वो डेवलप कर लेता है, और वो खुद एक न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म की तरह से जीना स्टार्ट करता है. अंडरस्टूड?
यस मिस, थैंक यू.
ओके, वेलकम बेटा.
Anyone else having doubts, raise your hands. Ma'am, no one is raising their hand.
Okay, ma'am.
Rehan, okay. Shay, unmute yourself. Ma'am, if you're having that last video, we'll play that video and then we'll end the session. Or else, if you're not having that, then please revise for some time. We are having 3 minutes still.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. I will just see.
Yes, okay.
Shilpa ma'am, you can take some evaluation questions. You can give them some homework.
Okay ma'am. Okay, I will try in our my next lecture. It is on Friday. I will put some evaluation questions in that. I will prepare one slide for that. And
okay.
I will add.
Okay. Because every lecture you have to end up with the evaluation. Okay.
Okay ma'am. Okay.
Hello ma'am, it's not audible. Have you started? Okay, thank you so much, Shilpa ma'am.
Okay ma'am, thank you very much.